do the stems. Just wanted to I made this a little bit bigger. I don't know if you can notice. And I added a little bit of the yellow bottom down here. I did drop a couple alcohol drips. Just 90% alcohol. Just a couple drips on the green to just make it a little bit more interesting. And I just want to do this here. That a little bit more life, and gotta do something around the bottom there. So I'm just gonna get the raw sienna with the water pen. Because that was just a little too light. And I think I'm gonna bring these down a little bit further. Some of them. Sorry for my noisy space heater. It's being very noisy. I think this worked better. I know it worked better with this tiny, fine brush. Either that or it's just too wet. Just trying to liven it up a little. All right. This all really, excuse me, comes to life once you start collaging and doing the pen work. So we have to do the stumps. I'm gonna use this, I can't think of the word, water soluble graphtone. What is the name of this that I have here? It's a Derwent Graphtone pencil, water soluble. This is just a 6B, and I'm just gonna like use it like a paintbrush and get the right brush here. So I'm gonna wet my brush. And then you just wet the graphtone. Sort of like a wash. It is a wash. Now I'm just gonna get a little bit of Payne's Gray. On a thinner brush, especially for the these guys. That's too thick. And she ruins the painting. What is my problem? All right. I'm gonna leave that alone for a minute. Try this a different way. Use the water brush. I know you guys can't really see where it's what. But this is a smarter way because you can just drop the ink into the wet. If I could see the wet. And then we'll just let cute. I wish I didn't do that. Oh well. Don't do what I did. Do this. Use a water marker or like a small dropper and get some water on this. You just squeeze the water brush. These I'm just gonna kind of like go off the page. Yeah, I kind of made a mess of these. Shoot. I'm going to use the heavy body Payne's Gray. See now, like, with watercolor paper, you can wreck it. It can't take that much abuse of me trying to wipe all that off. I know better than that. All right. Now, kind of just want this to fade. So I'm just going to use this wipe so that you still see the transparency on the bottom. And I'm gonna try to make a bit of a line here. Hopefully you'll learn from my mistakes and watch this through and make a better plan. Just want to get a straight line. Okay. And then I think very, very watery, I'll do these little stems. I'm like so paranoid now. Only mushrooms. I didn't get that guy. Put it over here. Just kind of give a little impression of it being there. It just kind of goes behind that one. I don't think we're gonna see it because of the dress. I can see some brush strokes, so I'm just, I don't want to see brush strokes, so I'm just wetting this a bit so that the heavy body, oh my gosh, I'm taking paint off. I need an intervention. Okay. And dry this. So next will be collage. There's our queen. I'm gonna get my matte medium. I'm just using the basics for now. I'll set that aside for a second. Let's figure out. Still have a little wet spot. Okay. I had to stand up. So this is the center. That looks about good. I'm just gonna take a little white charcoal and just mark where her head I want it to be. So this paper is see-through. I don't think we're gonna run into a problem, but I can always like do a couple layers. Yeah, we might. All right, well, we'll wing it. I like that part. So it's gonna go down to here. I'm just gonna do that straight for us. I do want it to come up a little. And I will have it end at the tape line. All right, well, we can always cut more away. So I'm just gonna take regular scissors. The charcoal will just wipe off with either wet your finger or a wipe. But make sure you do it before you put the matte medium on. Or you'll seal the chalk mark. You don't want that. Let's get her on first. So I'm just gonna take this old yucky brush that I don't care about for this part and get some matte medium. And I'm just just gonna seal the back of her. And I'm gonna put some right here. And then I'm gonna start right at the top. And I'm actually gonna use this little catalyst wedge. And then let's see if I want it that, yeah, I like it that wide. So I'm gonna take a wet wipe and take the charcoal off. Oh my gosh, I'm getting Payne's gray on it. There, it's fine. I need a little bit more matte medium. Put some down on the paper. And on the back. I hope I have my camera so that this is showing. And then I just start a little charcoal still on it. Okay. So it is a little see-through. This is when you sort of have to wing it. So I don't need this whole piece. But I do need the top, kind of. This is kind of a pain, but I'm sure there's other ways of doing it. What stinks is when you choose a paper and then change your mind and you cut it. I do that a lot. I want that to show. Oh no, I don't. All right. I might just keep going until I get like the pieces I want on it. You could also just use several different types of paper. You can use whatever you want. A little bit too much matte medium. Because if you use too much, that can cause wrinkles in your collage. I really like this flower here. Which one was it? Oh, I cut through them all. It's just like these little pieces. It dried. That was fast. All right. Take off what I don't need. So we only have one orange mushroom, but I could add like with a paint pen, orange polka dots somewhere, so I think that'll be fine. I do wanna do a crown. So I'm just gonna go in with a fine pen. Pencil. Where's my phone? I'm a hot mess. Oh my gosh, I'm recording. That's where my phone is. Hello, crazy person. So her crown, might need this actually. That's not right. I think it'd be easier to do points. And I'm gonna grab some metallic paint for the crown. I think I'm just gonna do gold. The gold will show up nice. So this is iridescent gold, deep fine fluid. that detail brush back to do my points. Usually do quite a few coats. And I'm gonna get a better tip there. Pointy. I also use a paint pen, especially to get the tips. And I think, like with the last one, I went through her hair. It's just connected it. Too much paint on there. Goes up into there, and fades underneath, and then I'll do one more coming down. And the other one, I just like to do a straight line on her shirt. I could do polka dots. You could do anything, really. You could paint it white. You could do whatever you want. But I do like the stripe. I am just gonna do it again. It's a little wet. I did put a little bit under her eye. Doing that. I can't remember if I did here. I think I did. I know I did at least like a band, I think. Doesn't really matter. We can do it different. Maybe like a belt. So this is gonna dry. I am gonna use just a Sharpie gold pen, paint pen. Just to get some really nice points. Like that. Give her a little earring. And I'm gonna give her a ring. Because she's a queen. So when this all dries, and it's getting late, the sun is down, in the morning, we can do the pen work, the fun stuff on the mushrooms, and finish it off. So I will see you then.